France was still experiencing the consequences of the 1789 revolution. The ringing of church bells was forbidden, and religious ceremonies were kept under surveillance. Emily's childhood was marked by respect and love of the family, with its joys and trials. One of her brothers lived only for a few weeks. Till the age of 7, her mother was her only teacher. She used to take her on her lap to teach her reading and to inculcate in her the faith. The first truth learned by little Emily was, God created us and He loves us. And her mother often repeated to her, your little brother is in heaven, where life is much more beautiful than here below. But the mother's health deteriorated day by day after the birth of her little baby, Maxima. The French Revolution had closed all the Catholic schools. At the age of 7, Emily was sent to the only school kept open in Gaillac, situated on the Rue de Langy, under the direction of Mademoiselle Duberville. Emily was 10 years old when the Bishop of Montpellier came on his pastoral visit to Gaillac and administered the sacrament of confirmation to the children, among whom was Emily. After receiving the sacrament, she asked God the grace to suffer for Him the pains caused by those who govern us. When she was 13 years old, her father decided to send her to Paris to continue her studies.
Le papa avait des idées pas très catholiques, mais il s'occupait d'un foyer pour les malades qui était tout près de la maison paternelle. Donc Émilie savait que son père s'occupait aussi des pauvres. Et il y avait dans ce foyer de pauvres, il y avait un tour, c'est-à-dire un endroit où on mettait les enfants abandonnés et on pouvait les récupérer, on les abandonnait là et on les prenait là. Donc Émilie, toute petite, a compris qu'il y avait des injustices, qu'il y avait des pauvres, elle voyait les enfants qui n'allaient pas à l'école, les enfants qui mendiaient dans les rues. Tout ça, ça lui a donné l'idée de s'occuper des pauvres.
In September 1810, the family accompanied Emily to Paris by stagecoach. When the mother arrived in the Rue de Condé, the home of her sister Madame de Lamourier, she felt extremely tired. She confided her 3 children, Emily, Augustin, and Maxima, to her sister. Madame de Vialard was happy to see Emily admitted as a pupil boarder in L'Abbaye aux Bois of the Congregation of the Sisters of Notre Dame, one of the best schools of that time. She entrusted to Emily the care of her little brothers and encouraged her to love Jesus. Then she closed her eyes and departed this world. She was only 34 years old. Imbued with her mother's lessons in virtue and used to her loving presence, Emily felt deeply the great void left behind by her absence and which her aunt tried to fill in part. She was greatly attached to her grandfather, the doctor, who loved to show her that joy still existed on this earth. Emily began to attend the Church of Saint Sulpice regularly, situated close to Baron Portal's house. At the age of 14, she made her first Holy Communion. She was very impressed. God, she said, began from that time to draw my heart to Him. Thus, her life became the daily expression of this union with Christ. There are flowers that blossom only in thunder and lightning. It was thus in Emily's life. When she was 15 years old, she had to return to the paternal home to stay with her father, who was suffering from loneliness, but also to look after her two brothers. Augustin, with a strong personality, and the little spoilt Maxima. Arriving in Gaillac, Emily was welcomed like a queen. But all that outward show far from dazzled her, because she thought only of her mother and of all the responsibilities which awaited her at home, apart from having to contend with Toineau, the housekeeper, who received her with a disagreeable, scowling face. Emily used to go with her father to all the worldly gatherings of the town. Besides, she played the piano quite well. So it was a beautiful young lady that attracted the attention of all the young men. But despite this worldly life, Emily felt in her innermost self the need for spiritual support. This impelled her, unbeknownst to her father, to go and pray in the Church of St. Peter. She still liked to pray secretly in her room. One day she says, "I was captivated, as it were, by God. I was suddenly dazzled and enveloped by a brilliant light. I sank to my knees." She understood that this vision, coming from heaven, brought her a message. It was then that she decided to consecrate her whole life to the Lord. 3 years after her return to Gaillac, Father Mercier announced that a mission would be preached in the Church of St. Peter. Emily participated, along with all the parishioners, in this kind of spiritual retreat. Towards the end of this exercise, she heard an inner voice, a voice asking her to renounce her worldly life and to begin her mission. One evening, she placed her jewelry in a box and decided to give up wearing it. From that time onwards, she began devoting her time to prayer and the service of the poor.